on it. Oh, hey, people.
Hi.
Hi. Gallery mode, yeah. Oh, I can see all y'all faces.
Looks beautiful.
Can you see me?
Yeah.
Oh,
I can see some of y'all. I think some people are loading.
I think my name is spelled. My name, yep, my name's spelled wrong. Oh my gosh, hi! This is
hi,
the coolest thing ever.
This is so fun.
Hi.
I'm kind of nervous.
Oh my gosh,
I don't know so many people on here.
I know, right? Oh my gosh, how are you guys?
Good. How are you working at home?
Good. Just hanging out. I was looking forward to this. Okay, well, I'm just going to kind of leave this whole thing. What I've been doing, I did like a virtual radio tour, which is something so new to me. So I did this with a bunch of radio stations, and obviously success. I got second most added. And then, yeah, so we're just going to play a little like clean, easy version of Never Have I Ever. And I'll explain it if you haven't played it. And then I'll sing a song and then we'll talk and then I'll sing another one and we'll take a picture on here. And then Yeah. What? Getting more people. Okay. Oh my gosh, even more. All right, so I'm just going to jump into this game. So if you haven't played the game Never Have I Ever, so basically I'm going to ask a question, like, for example, never have I ever driven a car? And if I have, I raise my hand. And if you haven't, obviously, and if you're confused in the game, you can ask anything. Super chill. I want this to be super chill. And then we'll talk about everything. It'll be fine. Okay, so the first question is never have I ever been in the pit at a concert. So I have before. Oh, nice.
What concert?
Any concert.
No, what concert were you at?
I was in the pit for Ariana Grande.
Okay. That was in Nashville, right?
Yeah. I like your beard, Brian.
That's my quarantine beard.
Yeah, right?
In the pit at your concert.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
I was in the one in Austin at the iHeart Country
oh
Festival.
Oh my gosh. That was a super fun one.
I was at
it
your
was kinda hot though.
Like 3 years ago.
Oh my gosh. Super fun. Okay. I'll just move on to the next question. Never have I ever taken off work or school for a concert.
Yours. Like all of yours.
Like three of yours, literally.
What school to make up for?
Oh my gosh, your release parties were right before finals week for me, and I skipped for Nashville and Houston. I'm not kidding.
Oh my gosh, I hope I didn't get in trouble.
Oh, Sam helped me with that.
Oh my gosh, anybody else?
I left school early like 7 times for concerts.
I think my first concert was for Jason Aldean, and I really cut it. I was like, I'm school for that.
I love doing that before. In middle school, me and my friend Ella left school early to Houston Rodeo to see Rascal Flatts. Crazy as that. But it was super fun. I would give anything to leave school early.
Yeah, I miss for Billy Currington. Billy Currington.
Oh, it's nice. Yeah.
For Taylor Swift.
So Kenny Chesney is actually one of my fraternity brothers. I got to skip school to help like set up for his concert and go to his concert. It was awesome.
Whoa. That's incredible.
That's super cool.
For your concert, when you were with Kane Brown and Granger Smith and I drove from New York on a Friday and completely ditched work to go there too.
Oh, That's awesome. Well, I hope we made up for that.
That was like my top three concerts. That was awesome.
Yeah, that was one of my favorite tours to be on. They're super, super cool. Okay, well, next one. Let's see. Never have I ever shopped for a specific outfit to wear for a concert. I've definitely done
that. There's no other way to shop.
You have to. I go with the cowboy boots and everything.
Yeah. I've done this for shows of mine. Like, I've been in a city, and I'm like, is there a mall really close? Because I was not really feeling anything that's in my suitcase, so I'm going to try to find something.
I like that. That's awesome.
Yeah, I'll be honest. I've done that many times.
No, don't touch me.
Pull this down.
I saw you walking out of Zara one time when it was like your gold tour or whatever in California, and I was like, oh my god, she's right there, and I was like trying to get a photo and stuff, and you were walking by. I was trying to be all sneaky. My family,
oh, shit, what are you doing?
I was like, I'm sneaking a photo, Danielle, I just saw her. So funny.
Saw me leaving my favorite store.
Literally.
Zara.
Yeah.
Well, I'll do one more question. Let's see. I'll take a good one. Never have I ever gotten to a show 5+ hours early.
Shit, what are I doing?
Wow, we're getting exposed right now.
I love it. I'm getting exposed.
Oh, there we go.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I've done that. Because Houston Rodeo is what I grew up going to.
No,
you know, I've gone in early to go, like, ride some rides and see all that stuff. But yeah, that's about it. Okay. So we played that game. That was easy. That was fun. But I am going to jump into a song if y'all are good with that.
Yeah. Yeah.
How it sounds on the other side of it.
Well, at least you can see it, but I'll try to get it. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I might be doing something wrong.
Weird. But to make it clear,
who says it's
on? Thinking, y'all can find the mute button on your camera, iPhone, phone, whatever. That'll make it easier. And then, oh gosh, this might be so. Oh, I'm new to this too. Good lord, my day today is like.
Hey guys, just go to speaker view so you can see Danielle bigger.
Perfect. If y'all can't figure it out, then don't worry about it. But I am going to throw it back to a line that I think we all know. It was super fun for me to write, and it's crazy how this song relates to what we're kind of going through right now. Yeah, I'm gonna sing Slay for you guys. So here we go. Hey, we're all in the same boat. Life can really suck sometimes. But hey, can't live in a shadow. So here's a little piece of advice. Stop by kicking off your shoes, even right by the door. Then you call a couple friends and you call a few more. Put a drink into your glass that'll make you let go. Then you find something smooth on the radio that makes you wanna sway to the left and sway to the right. Get lost in a groove that'll make you lose your mind. Put a smile on your face and you ride into a daze. No, there ain't nothing wrong when a song comes on that makes you wanna sway. Sitting around waiting for it to lay up. Let's break some rules and figure it out. Stop by kicking off
your shoes, leave them right by the door. Then you call a couple friends and you call a few more. Put a drink into a glass that'll make you let go. Then you find something smooth on the radio that makes you want to sway to the left and sway to the right. Get lost in a groove that'll make you lose your mind. Put a smile on your face and you're right into a daze. No, there ain't nothing wrong when a song comes on that makes you want to sway.
Time I sing that song, I build up so much spit in my mouth. I'm like, when do I fall?
It makes you want to spit.
Yeah, exactly.
You hit so, like straight chills all the time.
Oh, thank you.
Your voice is like amazing.
Thank you so much. Well, I'm glad.
So beautiful.
Thank you, guys.
Are you drinking matcha?
Yes, girl. I'll wait for my matcha drink from Starbucks. The Bennett story? Yeah, I have a few stories for you guys that a lot of people actually don't really know. Obviously, I'm in a new relationship, and y'all saw what a disaster the last one was.
It's okay. We don't have to talk about it if you don't want to.
No.
No, but a cool story about my new relationship. So I slid into his DMs. Such a first time for me. I am so shy when it comes to stuff like that. So I found him on Instagram, and the first thing I said, which I'm like, really, Danielle? Was like, have you ever been to Nashville? And I'm like, what kind of pickup line is that? And so I said that, and you know what he said back? He said, never have I ever. Have you ever been to LA? And I'm like, oh my gosh, what a coincidence that is. And so he said that, and I'm like, okay, well, I have this song, Never Have I Ever, and it fits perfect for exactly how I'm feeling. And yeah, I've always thought that was such a cool, ironic moment. And yeah, other than that, I am working on new music, which I'm super excited to tell y'all. I'm writing a bunch, and it's more down the Never Have I Ever lane. It's kind of like a R&B touch of country. It's not necessarily like pop country. I think R&B kind of makes it a little bit smoother, and it's just a fun mix. And I'm working on a lot of stuff, and I'm really excited for y'all to see everything, not just music side. Like, I'm really getting into the fashion side of things, and I'm super excited to share that with you guys. And yeah, a lot of fun stuff. And if y'all have any questions for me, I'm so down to answer anything. Yeah.
Any new merch soon?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm excited.
We should get hoodies, like crop hoodies.
Yes, crop hoodies.
Not for guys, though.
No, I'm definitely making sure everything is like guys can wear it just as cool as girls can wear it. And I'm definitely wanting to throw like hoodies in there, some beanies, caps, like t-shirts, shirts for us girls, and like a lot of fun stuff. I have a lot of fun stuff in the works for merch. So, yeah.
Love it.
Do you plan on releasing this song, Room for Two? It's like on YouTube, like a while ago.
Yeah. Oh, man, I missed that song. I haven't sang that one in a while. But
there's some more, but I forgot the name of them.
Yeah. No, but maybe. That song is such a cool vibe, and you never know. Like, I will wake up one day and be like, oh, I want to release Room for Two. So I need to go back and listen to that and see. I mean, you never know. We definitely.
I like the one called Speakers, too. Oh, I would jam that. I was in
college. Sam Hunt one.
Yeah. A lot of covers are coming soon. A lot of that.
Upstairs.
Stairway ones.
I didn't touch. That's where they are, though.
Yeah,
the acoustic ones are like awesome.
Oh, thank you.
I like Dancing in the Waves. You got me stuck on that one.
That is a good one. That is really good.
I was like, I have to learn this ASAP.
I need a little.
And then Bright, I think.
Yes.
Okay, so I got engaged on Memorial Day, and I know you sang at Shelly's wedding. Would you sing at my wedding? Well, with everything,
want to see this for?
It, but it's definitely going to be maybe like next May or June. Yeah. Like, in California. Like by Pebble Beach area. I don't know if you're familiar with it, but it's really pretty out there. So we're going to look at some venues. And I was like, oh my god, I was talking to my family. I was like, what if Danielle could see my wedding? That was literally that would be the best thing ever. It was so cool how you did that for Shelly.
Do it. Yeah, I know. Well, send me more of the information, and I'll definitely think about it. I'd love to. That'd be so fun.
Yay.
Yeah. I was super nervous about that, by the way. And Shelly's like my best friend. I've known her since like fourth grade.
Yeah.
And I have never been so nervous. I get nervous in the most weirdest situations. I don't know why.
I'm nervous right now, too. It's okay.
I don't know if you remember, but at the concert, the Kane Brown concert in Cedar Park, last year or the year before, I got to meet to you, and I gave you a like book of pictures I took from you.
I'm trying.
No, I have. Yeah, no, I remember that.
It was so cool because I was like in the front row at the concert, and I was like freaking out because I watched you since The Voice, and I was legit crying. I was like, oh my god, it's really her.
Well, I am just easy to talk to, so you're not too nervous about.
Hey, Danielle. So. Danielle, I have to say before, like my friend Michael Wise, the one that like let me like switch places because he had to work, and he just loves you. Like he's met you like several times. I know you probably remember him like from your in Nashville when you had like your meet and greet party, and back to when you did like your your first tour at the like Fillmore.
Yeah.
And do you remember that? Like yeah. Your like manager came over because he was flipping out, and he just loves you so much. And I'm so grateful to be able to take his place.
Yeah.
And I have to say that, like, he if I didn't say that to you, he'd be like, just tell him how much I love her.
I'll tell him I said thank you.
You're so welcome. But I actually did have a question. So one of the questions I want to ask is like, since you were so, you know, so young, starting like doing The Voice and having that experience, and kind of like where you took your music, like writing wise. Like, what's the biggest change, like, from now with, like, your new music? Like, what do you, like, feel like is the biggest difference? Or that you wish you would have told your, like, younger self? How about that?
Gosh. a lot has changed from The Voice, obviously. Mm-hmm. That whole experience was so just 16-year-old Danielle, like, tell me what to say, tell me what to do, because I have no idea what the heck is going on. And I had kind of the same conversation this morning. I had a phone interview, and she kind of asked me, like, how was the voice compared to now, and what have you learned? What have you taken away from that show? And I call it like a music industry boot camp in a way, because it taught me how to do interviews and be in front of the camera and my stage presence. And I feel like the biggest thing that has changed for me is my confidence, because I was like probably the most shyest girl you would ever meet in your
Maybe
life.
I can't get everybody in here, because I only see a few people. Well, see, I got other people here too.
I was super.
There's 21 surprised. People in there.
Yeah, right?
The participants, 21. So I can't see.
Uh-oh. And yeah, I feel like in my music too, the confidence has been there. I've been, I think, more and more vulnerable and more honest in my music, and especially starting with Never Have I Ever and with this new project of music, I'm definitely going to be more, you know, stick to my honest roots, and it's a little bit more vulnerable and just like a different phase of, you'll definitely hear the different phases of my life from, you know, last record and this one. So it's all really exciting, and I've learned so much. I'm just going to continue to go through different phases of my life, and you'll hear all different kinds of things, and just, it's super cool to just have y'all with me through all of these phases. So it's super fun.
Thank you.
But if y'all don't mind, I'm going to sing Never Have I Ever for you guys.
Oh, yes, please.
So here we go. Here's Never Have I Ever. Never have I ever been in love. Looking back, it all felt like pretend. Honestly, thought I knew what it was. Never have I ever, never have I ever felt my heart so calm and so excited at the same time. Thought you weren't real, but here you are. But never have I ever felt like, ooh, yeah, hey, got me confessing like this, heart on my sleeve, a mess, got me like, ooh, ooh, yeah, hey. Don't wear our words like forever. Never have I ever. Never have I ever lost my mind over someone simply saying my name. How did you make me the chasing kind? Never have I ever believed that a fantasy could be more than a dream. I'm getting caught up saying too much, so good you've done to me. I'm like, ooh, ooh, yeah, hey. Got me confessing like this, heart on my sleeve, a mess. Got me like, ooh, ooh, yeah, hey. Going around words like forever. Never have I ever. Never have I ever gonna be like, Yes. Amazing. Well, thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. I know it was a little short time, but we'll definitely do this again, and I hope to see y'all again, and hopefully shows and everything. And before we go, I want to try and take like a screen picture. So on my day-to-day,
I'm going
to set it up.
But everyone smile.
On the count of three, okay?
Oh, God.
All right. One, two, three. Yay!
Yay!
Yay! Thank you guys so much. And for y'all's support, I literally can't thank y'all enough. Like, I swear, hands down, I have, like, the best fans out of everybody. I'm because y'all literally are incredible. And I can't thank y'all enough for the support y'all have given me with everything from The Voice till now, and just the continued support. So thank you guys, and I hope y'all stay safe and have a wonderful rest of your day. Have a good weekend and all of the things.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks again.
Bye.